Well, a report in EWTN's National Catholic Register says that the Vatican is in crisis mode, management mode with Catholics in Germany. The story says in January, the two Holy See Cardinals wanted to bring the head of the German Bishops' Conference to Rome. They were seeking to correct him about an interview he gave in which he expressed dissent from church teaching. Joining us now is A.C. Wimmer, editor-in-chief of Catholic News Agency Germany. A.C., welcome back. Now, what did the head of the German Bishops' Conference say in the interview, and did the meeting in Rome ever take place?
Eric, good to talk to you about this. Yes, a meeting certainly did take place. And as to what exactly was discussed, of course, is open to interpretation following a pronouncement made by Bishop Batzing, but nothing too much coming from the Holy See. So all that we know is that in terms of what Bishop Batzing was saying, there may have been soundings of encouragement. But when you look at what Pope Francis has in fact said, written, and otherwise provided in terms of feedback, including from the Congregation of the Doctrine of the Faith, of course, is rather harsh criticism, which has often been framed as encouragement by those whom that criticism is addressed to, in particular German bishops. So the debate is open. And as to who will finally have the interpretation that will also constitute a decision on these important factors remains to be seen. As a Catholic, I'm sort of pegging my hopes on Pope Francis.
And AC, can you expand a little bit on the latest of Bishop Batzing and the church in Germany in general?
Well, the situation is really so serious that there are increasing calls for Pope Francis to make something of an emergency intervention, or perhaps invite the German bishops to come to Rome, or perhaps come to Germany. That might sound a bit dramatic, but only if you consider that the single issue currently at play is not the wider context. At the moment, Eric, the spotlight is on the question of blessings of same-sex unions. These are demanded by not only German bishops, but also bishops, theologians, priests from around the area, from German-speaking Europe, from Belgium. And yes, they are openly contradicting the Congregation of the Doctrine of the Faith. But if we zoom out and take stock of what Pope Francis is facing, you see that what's playing out is much bigger. What we're dealing with here, really, is a tension at a tectonic level with Teutonic bishops, with theologians, with the machine of structures and processes really well oiled by the German church tax system. And whilst the Pope has warned about these things, the tension is still ongoing, and it remains to be seen, as you've rightly said, how these things will play out.
Interesting, interesting. And let's switch gears a little bit, and we take a closer look at Easter. And what's the status of attending Mass in person in Germany during this coronavirus pandemic?
Oh, it's been nothing short of spectacular. Just before Easter, just before Holy Week, the Chancellor, Angela Merkel, together with the premiers, the state leaders of the different German states, announced that one should not attend Mass or any other liturgical celebration during Holy Week and Easter. And then 24 hours later, they backflipped on that, and now everyone pretty much can, if they want to, attend, provided they stick to the rules that have been successfully in place for a couple of months now. At the same time, there is a plethora of digital offerings available, especially, of course, on EWTN Germany, a German service provided here, and perhaps a bit on CNA Deutsch. But there's also a few other things you can do. Provided you stick to the rules, Mass is available, Easter celebrations are taking place, and in many places, of course, with really special traditions that include fires and all sorts of stuff going on.
But people are still taking precautions out there, right? Wearing masks, things like that, social distancing.
Whilst there's not a general rule for everything, in general, you cannot sing at church. You must wear a certain type of specific mask, a N95 or FFP2 mask. You must disinfect your hands. You have about 1.5 meters, I think that's about 6 feet distance to the next person, and there is no communion on the tongue.
Well, you stay safe out there. A.C. Wimmer, editor-in-chief of Catholic News Agency Germany, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you kindly, Eric. God bless.